Chandler Moore. Now, what is happening and what's going on? Now, I don't really personally know this guy. Obviously, I don't know him personally, but there's a lot of stuff going on in Christendom right now. And apparently, he just got married and he posed with his now wife. And they posed in some provocative pictures, or they made some provocative poses, wedding photos, time or whatever. I'm not really quite sure what happened, but I'm just gonna go through it. Upon looking at it, yeah, I was a little bit shocked and surprised. I don't really know this guy. I might have heard of his name flyby or whatever the case may be. And I think the question in mind is, what is he doing? Is it wrong to pose provocatively, to use provocative poses in a sexual manner that obviously enthuses sexual interest in people? I don't think there's a moral question to that. The only question that I have to it is, what were you thinking, or what are you thinking, or what are you actually trying to promote? Because that is the only thing that I'm trying to understand about this, is what are you trying to promote, really, and what are you trying to achieve? I think if I knew the person personally, I would have asked him, what is the point behind this? I mean, it's a wedding photo. We know that you are married now. There's nothing wrong with a married couple having sex in any way. But why do you need to show the rest of us? Why do we need to see that? I just don't get it. I don't get the idea behind that. We know that, of course, they're not really having sex, but they're mimicking the act of having sex, which is enthusing and interest immediately onto the looker. I mean, sex is moral. God created it to be moral. But the moment we make it immoral is when we start doing things that now take the focus and attention away from God to whatever it is that we're doing, whatever it is that we want with our heads. When we start getting our stupid heads into all these things, we start twisting everything into our own glorification and whatever it is that we are glorifying in that moment. If it takes moment away from Christ, and Christ is no longer the center focus of the marriage or the marriage celebration, and it becomes something else, it is that else that I'm questioning right now. And as I said, there's a lot of things that aren't wrong. There's nothing wrong with you being sexual with your wife. There's nothing wrong with you celebrating your marriage in a certain way. We know that you're going to have sex afterwards. We get it. But it's kind of like, you know, I mean, look, you're allowed to do that. It's your marriage. You know, it's kind of like driving. You have a license. You guys have a license to have sex. But just because you have a license to drive doesn't necessarily mean that you got a license to speed. So that's kind of like what it feels like. You know, you can just drive all over the road without whatever. There are boundaries, there are borders, there are rules of the road, you know, there are guidelines to everything. There are guidelines in marriage, there are guidelines to how we behave, you know. So it was just out of bad taste. I think if someone knows this couple, they probably should have told them that that's a bad idea. And as much as it's fun, you know, if you want to do your thing and whatever, and you're with your people, why are you posting it online for everybody to see? That's the other thing that we just can't seem to get it. We don't get it. We understand. We already know the scriptures. This is strictly to Christendom. I think Christians know very well. Okay, there's a lot of people who were posting, they were responding to the pictures on Instagram. A lot of them were saying, oh, it's fun. It looks like it was all fun and whatever. Yeah, I think there's a lot of people who, their knowledge of the scriptures and understanding of the Bible and the Christian faith is quite questionable. I don't think there's a question to that. There's no doubt about that. But at the same time, God is not what we make him. He's not who we say he is or what he is. But he is who he says he is. And it is important to understand what that means and what that represents. Hence, what we ought to be representing right now is Christ. The perfection, the glorious Father, that which he takes glory in. He doesn't take glory in us just, you know, posing in grotesque manners and behaviors that take away the focus of people. People's focus immediately. I mean, I looked at the pictures and immediately I was like, my mind immediately went into that. I mean, it was quite pornographic in nature in a way. You know. So yes, I use the word pornographic in case you're like, how is it pornographic? It's not, it doesn't have to be naked, because it enthuses the mind to think of sex, because it was you know, they were mimicking a sexual position. I mean, that's exactly what it was. I'm not somebody that casually looks at pornography. Let's just get that clear. And if I do look at pornography, it will be like once in a, white Christmas. I don't know. Because I'm not perfect. I'm not a perfect human being, you know. But it's not something that I go out looking out for. And that's what I'm trying to say. So therefore, those are things that I tend to avoid. So when I saw those pictures, even for me, it was kind of like, that's exactly where it kind of took me. It was kind of like, poof, whoa, you know. But it was like a little weird for me, you know, because that's not stuff that I'm thinking about. I'm not thinking about those type of things or anything like that. So I immediately can see that there's something very questionable about that. I love the captions. There was a lot of captions that was like, no marriage will be marriage without Christ in it or whatever. There was a moment where he took a picture and it seemed like it was crying or something, you know. I don't know him personally. Like I said, it seems like a Christ-centered dude. They seem like a Christ-centered couple. I think they just need better advice, you know. So if it's about Christ, let it be about Christ. Let's keep people focusing on Christ. Let's not really take people's focus away from God. Let's not steal the joy away from God with unnecessary pictures. I think it was just unnecessary and unwise. That's what it was, unnecessary and unwise, you know. All right, that's what I think, really, pretty much. I don't think it's a good idea for people to do that, for Christians to do that, especially for Christians to do that. Okay. All right, all the best, guys. Do like, do subscribe, do leave a comment, do tell me what you think about this.